Hey, what's up guys? Nuno here. Lumin has just released the new version, the 11.3. In today's video, I'd like to go through the most important features available in this new update. Before we start, I'd like to invite you to my free training, my top 10 secrets to achieve realistic 3D renders, where I share my secrets to have a realistic 3D render and show how to make this interior render in Lumin. So don't forget to sign up, I'll leave a link in the top right corner and in the description below this video. So without further ado, let's check the new features of Lumin 11.3. So let's start the video by talking about the feature number one, which is shadows for Omni lights. And these Omni lights are lights that cast light everywhere, like in a sphere. And before in Lumin, they didn't add any shadows, but now they do, they cast shadows. So let's have a look. In this scene, I will just lower here the sun height so it's dark, so we can see this effect a little bit better. I have here a sphere to work as a lamp. So let's go here to lights. Now on the second tab, we have OmniLight and we can select this one. And as I said, in early versions, this didn't cast any shadows, but now when you place it, it will automatically start casting shadows, and you can select here medium or high resolution. I'm gonna try to place this light inside this sphere. So more or less here, actually something like this. Okay, now that I have my light placed here inside this sphere, you can see that all the light is gone, right? I'm even going to change here the color a little bit to a more orange, and I'm going to increase a little bit the brightness. You can just see a little bit. And why? We need to increase here this shadow exclusion zone. So you see this sphere. Okay, now it's properly casting the light and the shadows. And as you can see, it creates shadows here. It's casting light everywhere, here on the ceiling. So you can increase the fall off as well. And this fall off, so the light will just travel until this distance, as you can see, and the shadows start to be a little bit more faint as well. So just reduce a little bit more or increase. I can increase the brightness. And also there's another thing that you can do. You can create highlights from these Omni lights. So let me demonstrate this to you let's grab here any car. Okay, it can be this one. Of course, you wouldn't put a car like this here, but for the purpose of this video, it will do. And let me put metallic paint. And now let's select here this light and let's click show light source. And now you see all the light highlights on this car. Before you couldn't see, and now you can see them. If I move the light, see, you will see these highlights traveling through the car. So this was one feature that you didn't add before as well. And of course, if you increase this brightness, it will also increase the specularity here. Okay, and this is for the shadows for the Omni lights. It's a very nice feature and I'm looking forward to explore more of this. Now, as for the second feature, it's multifunctional clip planes. So before, if you go to here, the utilities, you had this clip plane and you could only add one. So if you want to show some cut of your building, you can just select one like this and that's it. You can select this one, or you could, for example, you could rotate it and now you could show like this the cut. But now we can have multiple clip planes. So we can have this one. Now I add another one. And so now I can have this cutting from here, right? Let's say until here. And the second one, let's say I want a little bit further back, maybe until here. Okay. And you can have a total of three clipping planes. So let's actually select one more. And I'm going to rotate it, maybe this time like this and like this. Okay, so now I'm just seeing until this desk. So now I can cut in three different planes. So feature number three, it's new character silhouettes. So now, if you go to any character in Lumion, from these 3D characters, let's select this man, for example, and actually another one, this one. Now, if you select the person, you have this tab, Colorize. Before, you could just give it a full color, like this, and it will be white or black. But now, you have different shading options, like shaded or polygon. So polygon, you would see all of the polygons of the 3D model. Shaded, it gives you this more clay look. And you can leave, for example, this one like this. And this one here, let's select, let's click colorize. We have here selected shaded. And now let's give it a color, maybe something like this. Okay. So this new character silhouettes could be interesting to highlight different areas of your project. As for the feature number four, it's groups. They improve the way you can group objects in different categories. So let me show that to you. You can go here to nature, for example, and let's select some tree. I can select ones from the fine detail, the ones that have better quality. Can be some people. And maybe a car. Okay, so let's select all of them. Actually, you have to have here this tab, select all categories, okay, to be able to select from all the categories. And now you can group the objects, clicking here. And now you can see all the group linked together. And before, to be able to select these groups, you have to have all the time the select all categories. Now you can just select one of the categories, like for example, people, since I have people here, and now you are able to select this. But for example, if I select indoor or outdoor, I don't have anything, so I cannot select this group. But if I go to nature or fine detail or people or transport, I can select any of these objects. And I can change the properties like the color of this car, for example, without having to unlink the group. I cannot rotate individual objects, but I can change this type of properties. For example, if I go to this person, I can select this colorize, shaded, and for example, put a blue color. I can go to fine detail, nature, and select this tree, and I can adjust the color of the leaves to be more saturated, less saturated. So there's some improvements in this grouping, and I think now it's really becoming really handy, this new functionality. And feature number five, it's rendered grid and measurements. Before, in older versions of Lumion, you could go here to utilities and you find this measure tool here. And you can simply just go here and let's place it here. And now place it here. Okay, and I can actually, let's make it until this place here. Okay. And you can see here the angle and the measurements here. Just going to push this slightly forward, like this, and like this. Okay. And you can only do this in build mode in older versions. But now, if you click here, render, now if you go to the render, you can see here the measurements show up and you can display this in your final renders as well. To be honest, this tool could improve a little bit yet, because you don't have much control to where exactly you are placing this. Maybe you could align to the vertices, could be, or to the edges, could be a nice addition. So again, it's probably a nice feature for some people. I think it has still room for some improvement, but let's see what will come up in the future versions. And the next one is actually one that I really, really like. It's the no restrictions for fine detail nature. So now you can finally duplicate any fine detail nature elements in your scene using the Alt and then drag. It will duplicate these elements. Before, in older versions, you couldn't do this. But now, if you want to place many of them, they actually unlock this feature. And not just that, As I showed you previously, you can also add these elements to groups. Before you couldn't do that, so now if I select all of this fine detail nature, you can add all of them to groups. And not just this, you can add with multiple categories, nature, people, fine detail, you can all these categories can be grouped together. And also another thing that they did, let me just first ungroup this here, ungroup. You can select any tree of this fine detail, and now you have the ability to go, you click here on the side and then replace selection. And with this replace selection, you can go to any point here. Let's say I want, instead of this tree, I want to have some person here. It can be this one. Okay, and now it's replacing that tree by this person in the exactly same spot. So before you couldn't do this as well in the older versions. And feature number 7 is Light Gizmo. So they improved a little bit how the Light Gizmo works. I think many people complained when they had multiple lights in the scene, it would kind of look like a net everywhere. They couldn't really find anything because it was a lot of lines in the scene. So now, if you go here, let me just place a couple of spotlights to exemplify this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. Okay, I'm just gonna move it up. All right, something like this. So now this gizmo that you see here, so it will always remain with the same size. So if you go backwards, they keep the same size, but they don't occupy the full screen with these gizmos of the interface. So as you can see, if you go closer, you can still see them, but they are considerably smaller. And since we are here speaking of lights, I will move to my feature number 8, which is the updated lights color picker. So now if you click here to color, you can see that they changed a little bit how this looks, the color picker. So now you can select any color and then you can select here the saturation. You also have the show more, which is the use saturation and X color. And so this looks just slightly different than before. So now moving on to feature number 9, material highlight effect. We already had this feature before in previous versions, but now you can have multiple effects stacked on top of another. And this way you can have different highlights of different materials. So let me show you this to you. You can go here to photo mode. And now if you go to head effect, and let's go here to artistic tool, and we have here material highlight. So you select here on edit, which material you want to highlight. So let's say I want to highlight this here, this one. Okay, I press okay. And you can select the color, so maybe I'll select some, can be this green color. And you can select the style as well, so this style or this, the transparency. So I'll leave it like this, because it's quite visible like this. And as I said in the previous versions, that was it. It's the only way that you can highlight just one material. But now you go again to the add effect and select another one. Now let's select another surface, can be the glass. Okay, so let's make this glass maybe yellow. Okay, and with the same style. And now let's go again to the effects, material highlight. Let's select the floor. Okay, and now for this floor, let's pick blue color. Actually, a little bit brighter. And so you see that now you can add multiple material highlights, and it's quite easy and fast to do this. And for feature number 10, they also have now new beginner tutorials. So if you are just starting out and you want to explore a little bit better how the software works, you can go here. This will be prompt the first time you run the software, but you can always find here on the bottom and click to start the tutorial. And they have here one, tutorial one, camera control. And you want to save your current project, discard, I don't want to save. So now it's loading the tutorial project. And so now you can take all the steps here to really get you into the software the right way. And speaking of that, if you want a more advanced tutorial of how to make realistic renders with Lumion, I have a course for that. And I'll leave a link in the top right corner and also in the description below this video. And as for the final feature, number 11, conform to landscape. So this one If you go to landscape and let's raise here the terrain. This will do. Now you can select the nature, something more. Give me this one, yeah. And if you place this element here, okay, you see that they all the time stay vertical, so they don't really follow the terrain. So you can click here and press F, and now holding F when you move around, this tree will follow the terrain, okay? Of course, I don't think a tree would ever grow exactly like this, but it's a nice feature if you want to create a little bit of randomization, even with some things like the grass elements. You can always place them like this. And now if you select them, they as well will conform to the landscape. Just remember to press F, hold F, and then you can move around. And also, if you are interested in creating a realistic landscape with Lumion, I also have a video for that, and I'll leave a link in the top right corner and in the description below this video. What do you think of these new features? Let me know in the comments below. Also, don't forget that you can sign up for my free training, My Top 10 Secrets to Achieve Realistic 3D Renders. I'll leave a link in the top right corner and in the description below this video. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.